These learners from various secondary schools just won the essay writing competition about culture and the intangible heritage. They're being awarded with certificates and prizes to keep them motivated.
To be taught in class, then by getting some textbooks about culture, some videos, or to get any channel to give us more about culture.
It is very important to learn about our culture because it teaches us about the old morals, our cultural practices, the dances, the riddles, the folk tales, and many others. So I think we should appreciate who has brought up this program. I think it will help many more generations.
School cultural heritage clubs, in which learners engage in various activities like music, dance and drama, have been formed, all in line with promoting culture, which organizers believe can be used to inculcate discipline.
We tried by all means as the Foundation Uganda to work with the cultural heritage clubs in different schools, mostly we are in secondary schools, to train those girls and boys to know their norms and rituals and whatever, and practices of their culture. This helps the young generation to know where they are, where they are going, and what they are supposed to plan for next generation.
Moses Akugizibwe from the Uganda Community Museums Association emphasized the need for involving communities, especially the youth, in safeguarding the intangible cultural heritage elements.
To learn the same, but through these museum preservations, the children are using schools and the other forums, we will make sure that the new generation are able to learn and to know about our culture and history. And we are also supporting different aspects. But the most important thing is posterity, or preserving the cultural artifacts, those that shows our grandparents what they used to use, so that the new generation and the coming future children are able to know this history.
Some of the cultural heritage club patrons in schools have expressed their views on promoting culture.
Senior too, we have history where there is that chapter of culture and culture, family and values. So you cannot go away from your cultures. So when you're teaching history, there is that chapter whereby you have to put in. Then we put in practice, like in evenings, we create time when it is time for curricular activities. So as heritage members, we create time, we organize, we do some activities. On that issue still, there are sometimes when we have functions at school, then as these members, they go, they practice, and then they come, they show to the community what we all do.
This report was compiled by Roger Sunday for the news.